Hey everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, insertion and action of the rhomboid minor muscle. We can see pictured here the rhomboid minor muscle. And inferior to the rhomboid minor muscle is the rhomboid major muscle. The rhomboid minor muscle originates from C7 to T1 vertebrae, specifically the spinous processes of these vertebrae. So spinous processes, these little projections on the posterior of each of these vertebrae, which you can see right here. And in addition to the spinous processes, it also originates on the neutral ligament. So the neutral ligament, you can see right here, and it's originating from the external occipital protuberance and coming all the way down to C7. So it's kind of running along the back of these spinous processes. And on the inferior portion of the neutral ligament, that's another origin of the rhomboid minor muscle. So moving on to the insertion next, you can see it highlighted here in blue, and that's on the medial border of the scapula, specifically the superior part of it. And just inferior to that, you're obviously going to have the insertion for the rhomboid major muscle. Now, if you're looking for a way to differentiate between the two insertions, you've got the spinous scapula right here. And if you follow that along, you've got the root of the spinous scapula. So just inferior to the root of the spinous scapula, you'll have the rhomboid major insertion, and superior to the root of the spinous scapula, we can see here the rhomboid minor insertion. So we're back again with the skeletal model, and you can see the rhomboid minor muscle originates on C7 to T1 spinous processes of the vertebrae. You'll also have the neutral ligament coming down here, which is another origin of the rhomboid minor. We've got the insertion, you can see here in blue, and similar to the rhomboid major muscle, the rhomboid minor muscle is going to assist in retraction of the scapula. So retraction of the scapula is when the scapula is going to move in a medial direction towards the spine. So we can see right here, I'm retracting my scapula, so it's moving medially. Another action of the rhomboid minor muscle is rotation of the scapula. So the scapula will kind of rotate in this direction, just like that. And that's going to depress the glenoid cavity. So the head of the humerus sits inside the glenoid cavity, which you can see right here. So as it turns, it's going to essentially lower it. So it'll be a little bit lower right here. That's going to help in stabilizing the head of the humerus during various movements to prevent injury and help it perform its actions. So if you'd like to learn more about the rhomboid major muscle, I've got a separate video on that, so check out the description box below. You'll be able to get all the details following the link there. If you enjoyed the video, you know which buttons to press. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. I'll see you all next time.